Are you looking for a unique homemade holiday gift to give to friends and family? Well, with homemade sodas being all the rage in restaurants, I thought it'd be fun to invite my next guest, who not only teaches soda making, but is also the proprietor of Brooklyn's PNH Soda and Syrup Company. Please welcome Anton Nocito. It's so nice to have you here, Anton.
Thank you.
Now, Anton has just admitted that he's never been on TV before. Well, guess what? Forget it. Just show me how to make syrup.
Absolutely.
I want to make syrup and soda.
Yeah.
And I did. I tasted many of your delicious syrups, and I liked
the quince,
the cream, and the lemon.
Grapefruit.
Oh, grapefruit.
Yes.
Grapefruit. I liked that very much.
Yes.
And Matt, you were a butcher.
I was a butcher.
So how do you go from that to artisanal syrup maker?
I just wanted to own my own restaurant someday. It's always been a dream of mine.
Uh-huh.
So I figured from butchering, I went to culinary, and then 12 years later, here I am making soda.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
It's good. It's been a dream to own an old-fashioned soda fountain.
Absolutely, yeah. As a child, I always remember going to them, and it's always been one of those restaurants that have played around in the back of my head.
Well, I have my sleigh, and I have my horse, and I'm going to come and buy horse and sleigh to a soda fountain.
Oh, fantastic.
And wouldn't that be fun? That's
absolutely
my dream, if I could only find that place. Yeah.
That'd be cool.
So I've been hearing that you are very experimental. You work with all kinds of seasonal fruits.
I do a lot of seasonal fruits, absolutely.
Yeah, so today you're going to show us how to make cream soda.
Yes.
Okay, now I have no idea. I love cream soda. I love old-fashioned cream soda. But I have no idea really what makes cream soda cream soda.
It's vanilla bean.
Oh.
Yeah, straight up. I mean, it's a really basic thing.
And
we also caramelize the sugar.
Okay, and you're using a natural sugar.
Yeah, I use organic cane sugar.
Oh, that's good.
Absolutely.
So 2 cups?
2 cups.
Okay, 2 cups of natural cane and 1/4 cup of water.
Yeah, just to get the caramelization going.
And so you just swirl that around.
I usually maybe give it a little mix just to get it going.
Oh.
Yeah, and I turn it on.
Okay.
Which we can...
That would be a good idea.
It'd be fantastic.
And then melt the sugar in that little bit of water.
Absolutely.
And caramelize it.
Caramelize it.
So is that one almost done?
This one's getting there, yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, how dark would you want it?
I go to 280 degrees, but usually dark amber is good.
And if you have trouble caramelizing, you can use just a wet brush and go around like this, or just cover the pot,
Cover the pot, yeah. Absolutely.
So now you make giant batches of this.
I make
this
bigger
stuff.
Batches, yes. 2 cups.
Not enough. So how dark?
We're almost there. Yeah, I mean, you could pretty much add what we...
So now what do you do to that?
I'll turn it off because it's never a good thing to pour cold into boiling.
Into the boiling
liquid.
Okay, and so you add to that?
Add to that a little bit. We'll add 2 cups of water, and I'm going to go a little slow because it's going to bubble up.
There
we go.
And should I turn it back on again?
Let's turn it back on again.
Okay, so 2 cups of warm water.
Yep, and then I'm going to add
juice of one lemon.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
That gives it some acidity.
Right.
You need that balance with the sugar. And then we'll bring this back up to a boil.
Okay.
Do you want to scrape the vanilla bean?
You do it.
Absolutely.
Do it.
We'll add one vanilla bean.
One whole vanilla bean.
It's a nice vanilla bean right here.
Yeah, plump and nice. Yeah,
absolutely.
Maybe Madagascar.
Yeah, very nice.
Where else do they come from?
I get Tahitian vanilla beans.
Oh, yeah, Tahitian.
Yeah. Mexico.
Okay, and all that vanilla.
Yep, you want all that good stuff right there.
Okay, and so just bring that to a boil?
Yep, bring that to a boil, and then I let it steep for an hour.
Okay.
I think we have...
Oh, yeah, that one's done.
We have some steeped vanilla bean here.
Okay. And so this we... That's done?
Yeah, that's ready to go.
Oh, so it's very easy.
Yes. But the magic of television, I guess.
Okay, so use a funnel. These are cute jars. Are these your jars?
I use these similar jars, absolutely.
Oh, it is syrupy.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. So it really does get syrupy. And you don't want to lose any of those vanilla beans. Vanilla bean seeds.
That's going to sometimes people are like, wait, is that dirt in there? But no, it's fresh vanilla bean.
Right. So fill up your bottle. And then just cork it, and you have a very nice gift.
Absolutely.
But make a label so that they know what to do.
Absolutely, which we have some labels
here. Okay, so make me a drink. I want soda.
You want a drink?
Yeah.
We can do that.
Wait,
yeah, there you go.
I made a mess. Now you have to wash the whole bottle.
That's all right.
I wasn't watching. There.
I've done it many times.
Okay.
All right.
Beautiful.
So let's make a couple sodas here. I don't normally put my hands on the ice, but I'm going to do it today.
Okay, well, that looks good.
Yeah.
So
I like to fill...
Now, why? What's the popularity of soda? Why? People are just sick of all the excess sugar
Absolutely.
And chemicals that are in
I started
commercial.
Teaching the class this year. Mainly, I think a lot of people are a little tired of drinking that commercial, ultra-processed, you know, super... just manufactured, just... You know, when you make it at home, you know where it's coming from.
Right.
You know what's going into it. You can use really high-end products.
Oh, now what's that?
This is the SodaStream.
Oh, SodaStream. What's that do?
This makes carbonated water, basically, like seltzer water.
Oh, so you can make your own seltzer.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You don't have to buy those little cartridges that, oh.
This has one big cartridge in the back. But this
and what
will
is
do
seltzer
like
60 bottles.
Seltzer water is water with CO2 in it. That's
okay.
Basically what it is. And it's good if the water's cold, it carbonates
has
much
that,
better.
Has that been made yet?
No, I'm going to actually, it looks like I'm going to do
watch
this
everybody.
Yeah, so it's just a few pumps. It's going to make a little noise right there. That's sort of the valve releasing.
Okay.
And then now you can see the
bubbles.
Oh, how
great.
Yeah.
So
and,
you can you bottle it up?
You can, this will last, in, like you could put this lid on this and put it in the refrigerator.
Right. How long will it stay?
A couple days at least.
Really?
Yeah, at least.
That's
usually
fun.
In my house it goes two bottles a day, so it's
okay.
No problem. So I'm going to pour a little bit of
Oh, I have fizzy soda.
Yes.
Fizzy cream soda.
Yeah, and we give it a little stir. This way you get all that.
Yeah. Oh, it's so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, really good. Have you ever done sassafras?
I'm working on a sarsaparilla. I'm working on a birch. I'm working on a cola.
Good. Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
I love birch soda, too.
Yeah.
That would be so much fun. Well, this is a very easy family project and a great gift idea. And to top it off, thanks to our friends at SodaStream, you're all going home with a soda maker just like this one. Thanks so much, Anton. Good luck.